Welcome to yoga. My name's Hayley. Good to have you here with me. Just make sure that you've got a nice amount of space around your mat and let's get warmed up. If at any point anything feels wrong, then please do stop. Take the feet wide to begin. We're just going to inhale, look up. Exhale, come down towards the floor. Bend the knees, lift up. Start to cross the arms if that feels okay for the shoulders. Big breaths here, trying to fill the whole of the lungs. And we're squatting into the knees. So as your knees and your legs start to warm up, make that squat a little bit more defined. Looking up, warming through the neck. Really reaching up out of the pelvis. Last two. Last one. And now just a down and up squat. So just starting to warm up through these quadricep muscles. You can have your hands on your hips. So we're going to be working these today with our warrior two poses. Last three, two, one. Step in, let's warm up the shoulders. We're going to draw a big figure of eight with the arm. So you can have a gentle sway through the hips. And try and keep that arm straight. If this is all too much, then remember, if you joined me earlier in the week, this is always your option. Otherwise, big figure eight, three, two, one, and the other side. Keep breathing deep, add that swaying through the pelvis, warming up through the thoracic spine. Your option is here. Last three, two, one. Gentle twist, lifting the heel as you twist round. See how far you can get your arms around your body. Keep the shoulders heavy. Last three, two, and one. Let's come into our sun salutations. So towards the top of your mat, so you've got space to step back. Inhale, look up. Exhale, forward fold. Just hang here for a couple of breaths. You might want to pedal out through the legs. Feel that tightness down the back. Bow the head towards the knees. And inhale to stand, look up to your hands. Exhale, palms by the side. Inhale, reach. Exhale, fold. Inhale to rise, reach, reach, reach for the sky. Exhale, palms by the side. Inhale, reach. Adding on, exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. So can you find that letter L shape? Your eye gaze is down to the floor, not to your toes. And think of the length from the crown of the head all the way back to the tailbone. Brace through the core, exhale to fold. Inhale to rise, look up. Exhale, palms by the side, a little quicker. Inhale, reach. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale to reach. Exhale, palms by the side. Adding on. Inhale, reach. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Step back, plank. Hold here. Find your strong plank position. If this is too much, you're on your knees for the option. You're pushing the floor away actively through the heel of the hand, wrists underneath shoulders, core is braced. Bottoms down, so make sure you're not in a jackknife position. Make sure you've got a straight line from the crown of the head to the heels. Walk the hands back towards the feet, so you're in forward fold. Inhale to rise, add a back bend here if you want. Exhale, palms by the side, step forward again. Reach. Exhale, inhale, halfway lift, exhale, plank, lowering down to the floor, so either in one straight piece or knees, chin, chest, into your cobra or up dog, and then back into your down dog as you exhale. Pedal out the legs, take the dog for a walk, and think about getting those hips really high, eye gaze to your knees, walk your hands back to your feet, so you're in your forward fold. Inhale to rise, back bend if you'd like it. Exhale, palms by the side. Step forward. Inhale, reach. Our first full salutation. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plank. Lowering down. One straight piece or knees, chin, chest. Up dog or cobra. Exhale, down dog. Lifting the leg, making your way to the top of the mat. So stepping it between your hands. If it doesn't reach, put your hand around your calf and step forward. Exhale over the legs. Inhale to rise. Exhale, let's go again. Breathe. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plank. Lower down. Knees, chin, chest, or one straight piece. Up dog or cobra. Exhale, down dog. Make your way to the top of the mat. One leg through, the other leg through. Exhale over the legs. Inhale. Back bend. Exhale. I'm just going to cue the breath. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale. Well done, everyone. Take a leg behind, reach up. Feel your heart rate should be higher now. We've got the blood flowing. You should be feeling warmer. And switch. And back to center. All right, grab a drink if you need. Come down to all fours. So if you were here with me earlier in the week, we were working on our half bow and our full bow pose. So we're going to work on that again today. But let's just mobilise through the spine by dropping the belly, lifting the chin into our cow pose and rounding through into cat. So inhale into cow. Exhale as you round through into cat. Think about working all the vertebrae, moving all the vertebrae in the back, right from the neck down into the coccyx. Last round here. Sit back in child's pose, just release any tension. Bow the head down, and then slide through onto your tummy. Let's come up into cobra. So hands are underneath shoulders, let's lift up, elbows in, and back down. So like a wave of motion here, up and down. Inhale to lift, exhale to lower. Two more. Keeping the legs grounded down, tops of the feet onto the floor. And holding still. Outstretched arms and legs. And then let's have a go at lifting opposite arm and opposite leg. So eye gaze down to the mat. Can you squeeze your glute, the muscle in your bottom, to lift the whole of that quadricep off the floor? So keep the knee straight. Last one each side. Bring your forearm across the body so you can support your weight and take hold of the foot. Now you could be here just holding and feeling that stretch down the quadricep, or you can start to lift the quadricep muscle, the front of the thigh, off the floor. This is our half bow pose. And switch. Make sure you're using this forearm to push you away from the floor. And you can alternate your legs, or you can have a go now coming into full bow, lifting the chest, lifting the legs, kicking the feet back into the hands. Last two breaths, and slowly release. Sit back into wide leg child's pose, extended child's pose, knees are wide, reach the hands forward. And slowly coming up. Come into a wide leg standing position. Inhale to lift. Exhale down the middle, forward fold. Let the head hang. And once you get down there, you might realise you can take the feet a bit further away. Think about dropping the head down to the floor. Slowly unfurl the spine to come up. Turn your toes to the side. We're going to come into our warrior two. So check. You've got a nice 90 degree bend through this front leg. This back leg is long and locked, foot grounded on the floor, and your arms are horizontal. So chip at that back hand that it's not down here. Arms are horizontal. Head, heart, pelvis in a straight line. And then your eye gaze is relaxed over your front fingers. Big breaths here. Come into side angle. So forearm to thigh. Reaching over, shining your face and your chest up to the sky. Now this top arm is tense. It's not just kind of flopped down here. Make sure it's energetic and you're reaching away. Without moving the legs, can you just move the upper body to reverse your warrior? Looking up to the ceiling. Or the sky if you're outside, without moving the legs, side angle. Legs stay still, discipline. This is how we build strength in those quadriceps. Come back to your warrior two. Straighten that front leg. Ooh, should have felt some fire in there. Toes back to the front, let's go on to the other side. So reset, warrior two. 90 degrees through the front knee. Back leg is long and locked, arms are horizontal. Eye gaze towards the front fingertips. Big full breaths here, filling the whole of the lungs. Coming through into your side angle, resting gently on the front leg. Try not to dump all of your weight on that front leg, stay lifted through the torso. Top arm is energetic, spread the fingers wide. Without moving the legs, switching to reverse. Hold it there. Without moving the legs, switch. So we're building strength in these leg muscles, the biggest muscles in the body, the front of the thigh. Make them work. Switch. Slowly coming back to your warrior two. Straighten that front leg. Ooh, toes to the front. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, down the middle.
Just walk your hands back further behind you. Let the head hang. And slowly unfurl. So one vertebrae at a time.
All the way up, and we'll come into our balance. So heel toe in. We're going to go into warrior one to begin. So taking a step back, bending through the front leg. Now with warrior two, our hips were facing the long edge of the mat. With warrior one, you want the hips to be facing the short edge of the mat. So arms come up. Try and get your biceps up close to your ears. And again, energetically lift through the the front leg so that we can move into warrior three, floating the back leg up. Now imagine you're being pulled in both directions. So someone's pulling your fingers, someone's pulling your toes. Now you can stay here, you're still balancing, or you can take hold of the foot like we did with bow pose on the floor and come into your dancer's pose. So kick the foot into the hand, grain of rice between the thumb and first finger. Slowly come up to standing with control, bring the knee up first and then pop it down. Well done. Other side. Warrior one. So hips to the short edge of the mat. Arms come up. Reaching up out of the pelvis so your weight is all dumped into your hips, lifting up. When you feel ready, start to load up the front leg so you can take the back leg off. And reach. Now you can stay here, you're still working on your balance, or you can take hold of the foot, come into your dancer's pose. Maybe find a focal point on the floor to help. Fix your gaze, fix your mind. Last two breaths. Slowly bring the knee up first and then place it down with control. You should feel that in the glutes as well when you come into that dancer's pose. Come down into a squat. So heels can be down or heels up. We're working on our balance here, so brace through the core, hands together. If it's all too much, you can rest your hands on the floor. Choose which option is good for you. Now without using the hands, can we stand and rise all the way up, reach up onto tiptoes. Reach for the sky, you can open the arms if that feels better for the shoulders, but you're high up onto tiptoes. And then slowly allow everything to come down. Well done. So balance is something that really deteriorates as we get older, so we need to keep working on it. You can try brushing your teeth each day on one leg, just to start working on those balance muscles. Let's come into a seated forward fold. So I've been doing this with you with both legs out. Today we're going to try one leg in, so your pelvis is now facing between this V, and we're going to lift up and twist and fold over the leg. So if this isn't good on your back, then please go back to this one that we've been doing with both legs outstretched. Think about lifting up first before you fold over. And then see if you can soften through the back of the leg, encouraging the head to come down towards the knee. And your hamstrings take time to soften and to stretch, so try not to rush this. Just with every couple of breaths, see if you can move a little bit deeper into the stretch, keeping the toes active. By drawing the belly in like you're wearing a tight pair of jeans and see if you can fold over a little bit more. Last two breaths. Slowly unfurl up and let's go to the other side. So other leg outstretched. So your pelvis is facing towards the V, we lift up, we twist towards the outstretched leg, and then we fold over, taking hold around the calf, around the shin, around the ankle, around the toes. And your
find, this is my least flexible side, you'll find that one side might be more flexible than the other. So just soften, encourage your head down towards your knee. Draw your belly in, see if you can fold over just another couple of millimetres. Last two breaths here. And slowly unfurl all the way up.
Bring the soles of the feet together. Now we're trying to encourage the knees to come down here. So you might need to move your bottom closer to your feet. You might want to add in some soft, gentle movement just to encourage those knees to go down. And you'll also find that if you press the pinky toe side of your feet together and open the big toe side, that allows the femur to drop a little bit more into the hip socket. If this isn't good for your back, if you're very hunched in this position, it's best that you take your hands behind you, lengthen through the spine, and then use the resistance of the floor to encourage the knees to come down. And again, you can add that soft, gentle movement. You should be feeling quite an intense inner thigh groin stretch here. Last couple of breaths. And then come into a comfortable seat. So that can be cross-legged, that can be up on your knees, whatever feels good for you. Open the arms wide. Take your right arm underneath your left. Cross and then cross again, coming into eagle arms. So lift the elbows away and then push the hands away from the face. So from the side, we don't want the hands in close to the head. We want to push those hands away. You should feel a really nice back stretch here. Last breath here, and release. Just roll out through the shoulders, and let's do the other side. So arms go wide, switch with the other arm underneath. Now, if that's all too much, you can just hug here. Otherwise, try and cross again with the hands, and then think of lifting up and hands drawing away. Feeling that stretch across the upper back. Last breath here. And slowly releasing. Coming down onto your back. We're just going to go into a twist. So knees are bent. Drop your knees to the right. Arms go wide, head to the left if that feels okay in your neck. We're just trying to wring out that spine before we move into our relaxation. And if you want to extend this here, you can lift the top knee closer to the body. You can even take hold of the top foot, outstretching the leg. Slowly come back to centre. Let's switch to the other side. Choose your option. You can play around with this top leg. And just coming into a relaxing position for you. So ideally, you want the legs outstretched. You want the feet flopping out to the side. Just snuggle your shoulder blades underneath you so that your hands can shine up to the ceiling. And just be still. Just scan through your body and see where can you soften? Where can you give way to the floor? Through your feet, your ankles.
behind the eyes. Deepen your breath, so big inhales through the whole of the lungs, sitting up tall. Let's finish with three big inhalations, so reaching up, look up to the ceiling, exhale out all the stale air. Inhale, reach up, exhale. Can you make this your biggest breath? Inhale, reach. Thank you so much for joining me, everyone. Do leave questions, comments below, and I'll see you again soon. Take care. Bye.